Hi, I'm Susan Devitt. I'm a solutions engineer here on Snowflake's industry solution development team. My team develops solutions for Snowflake customers and partners. And today I'm going to talk about a medical imaging use case where we've developed parsing for Dicom images and also a pneumonia detection algorithm using PyTorch in Snowpark. I'll walk you through our use case as well as the code and then show the Streamlit app that we created. So this use case here, if we think about use cases in the healthcare data cloud, this is squarely looking at unstructured data analysis. So here we're processing images. If you're not familiar with Dicom, Dicom is a image format type that essentially is an image with associated metadata. Dicom images can be from, you know, a single image up to, you know, hundreds of, say, you know, CT images all bundled together in a single file for a single patient. We are going to show in this solution both some processing and parsing of the metadata for those Dicom images bringing into Snowflake, as well as our machine learning solution to actually detect pneumonia using Snowpark. So if we think about pneumonia specifically, early diagnosis of pneumonia is very important to ensure, you know, prompt curative treatment. Pneumonia is a leading cause of death in many parts of the world, but it can be quite challenging to diagnose because there's some subjectivity in there, and there's often can be a lag in terms of the time needed to actually analyze and get a diagnosis back from a radiologist. Here we're going to present a tool that can be used for decision support that within seconds can give a probable diagnosis and be able to, you know, help inform healthcare providers, providing, you know, an additional data point for them as they care for their patients. This solution, as I mentioned, brings Dicom data into Snowflake, trains a model using Tensor Flow in Snowpark, and then we have a user-defined function to actually do inference on that trained model to detect the probability of pneumonia. So this can be really important because, as I mentioned, because pneumonia is so serious, that increasing the speed and throughput of this detection can really save lives. Being able to have, you know, when an image pops up, also have a score could really aid healthcare providers. And it also shows the art of what's possible here within Snowflake. It's also can be quite important to add accuracy and aid healthcare providers, and something that can be, you know, kind of a variable and subjective process. So the goal here is to show something that could be used as a decision support tool for medical professionals. So if we think about medical image processing and analytics, this is a solution architecture for this solution. We can see typically, you know, users would have an image taken, you know, X-ray machine, that image would get uploaded into an on-prem system. It might go into a Dicom web server. If it's an Azure Dicom web server, that data will go into Microsoft Azure Blob Storage, those images themselves. Here we're showing an external stage reading the data into Snowflake from that storage integration that's created on that external stage containing the Dicom data. First, I'll talk through actually running the Dicom parser. What this does is it takes anytime a new image is added into the stage, it finds it, it sees there's a new image, it extracts the metadata and writes that into a Snowflake table. This can be really helpful because that metadata is really rich information, right? If I wanted to go through and actually see, you know, where do I have chest X-rays that have a probable, you know, positive diagnosis for pneumonia, I could query that metadata and return that result. The second part of the solution that I'll talk through is our machine learning pipeline. So the first step that we do here is vectorizing and pre-processing on the image so that we can standardize those images, get them into an array that we can use with our machine learning model. We'll actually train a TensorFlow model in Snowpark. using a stored procedure. So this lets a user who, you know, isn't actually interacting with the code, they can still actually, you know, train the model on the latest images that come through if they want to. They can alter some parameters as well. I'll talk through that. And then once the model is trained, it's saved as a model object in a Snowflake stage. And this can really jumpstart being able to get this model into our production system. Because once we have the model saved in an internal stage, we need to write a user-defined function, but we can just call that train model to do inference, to essentially tell us on any new images that come in, does it have probable pneumonia? And I'll walk through that when I go through the demo. The last piece that I want to go through is our Streamlit UI. This is an application that we built on top of the solution. This lets you extract the metadata. This lets you actually train the model, vectorize those images, and then run inference on some new images. And I'll demo all of that for you today. All right. So what we're looking at here, this is our Streamlit application that's been built on the solution. This solution accelerator has a series of setup steps that will actually create those stored functions and procedures. It actually will even upload some sample data and then load in the training data set. First thing that I want to show here is our Dicom metadata. So what I'm doing here, every time I click refresh, what I'm doing is I'm going to that external stage. I'm checking to see if there's any new images, and then I'm running a PyDicom library to actually parse those that metadata and then write it into Snowflake. You can see that metadata comes in its raw form as a JSON, which here I have saved as a variant column. If I wanted to, I could create a view on top of this to have it look more like columnar data. But I can still, using Snowflake's JSON capability, I can query even this variant column here. So that's ingesting that DICOM information. What happens when we actually get these images in? So the first thing that we want to do is we want to actually vectorize those images. So do some pre-processing, have everything in a standardized size. Here I'm using 150 by 150. And we actually vectorize, convert that image into array using the skimage library here. So that's what I'm doing here on these images. And in my data set, I have about 3,000 total images that I'm using. About 2,000 of those have been already pre-classified as having pneumonia, and about 1,000 of those are classified as normal. So this will be the data that I'm using to train my model. When I want to train my model, I mentioned here that I am using Tensor Flow. So here I have a couple of parameters that I can set. Again, the stored procedure to train the model has already been created. What I'm doing here is calling that stored procedure with the images that I want, with the parameters that I want. So here, for instance, I can train my model. I can vary the size of the training set. I can vary the number of epochs in my TensorFlow model. And then I can actually train my model. It takes about 5 to 15 minutes, depending on how many epochs and how many images you choose here. So I'm going to show you a model that I trained a little bit earlier today. This model that I have here, you can see this report that I've created, where I can look at my overall accuracy score. I can look at how my loss is converging over those epochs. I can look at my overall, you know, different classes. I can look at F1 score, precision recall, and then here I've got my confusion matrix. So I can see overall my model is doing quite well differentiating between, you know, a normal X-ray and a pneumonia X-ray with very few false positives and false negatives. So this gives me some confidence that this might be a pretty good model, and I can go now and try to run some inference. So
So I've saved that model object that I trained earlier. And now what I can do is actually call that model for any images that I choose. I'm going to do here, I'm going to choose two images that have pneumonia and two images that don't. And I'm going to run my model and see how I do. So what the model is doing here, it's taking those images in, it's doing that pre-processing, and it is then running those new images here, these new four images against my my stored model in the stage. It takes a couple seconds to run, but not too long, and then I'll get those images back and be able to see what my model is predicting. All right, so I got my results back here. What I'm seeing here is that anything above 50 is my model says is pneumonia. Anything below 50 is not going to be pneumonia. So here we have percent pneumonia is 22, and we see we had a normal diagnosis. We can contrast that here with something like the prediction for pneumonia of 81, where there was a true pneumonia there. So this gives an example how as new images come in, we could run and trigger that UDF and then get a probable diagnosis or a percent diagnosis that could be helpful in diagnostics. Thanks so much for watching today. And if you'd like to learn more and see more of the code behind the scenes, my colleague Karuna, who wrote the machine learning pipeline here, he has an excellent blog post available on Snowflake Medium, where he walks through the solution as well as a lot more of the parameters that actually went into that TensorFlow model. Thanks so much for watching today. Please put any questions that you have into the comments below, and I'll see you on the next video. Thanks.